I met Sam out the front of uni one day, having a coffee, and I think he overheard me or I overheard him say something about Tom Waits, and then we just kind of started up a conversation there, and he mentioned something about this project he was doing. He had a singer but no drummer or bassist. And then we had another singer called Reggie, who awesome dude, left for work commitments, and we were introduced to Matt, and as soon as he stepped in, just worked. And then we knew Dale, all of us had known Dale for years through uni, and we heard that he could play trumpet, brass, and we knew he was a drummer obviously. And originally we just asked him to just play a few shows with us as a bit more of a session guy. Just through some parts that we had, and then a few months later we were writing more tracks that involved a lot more of Dale.
And it sounds exactly how you need and want it to sound, like in that scenario.
I'm fine with that.
Just the feeling translation, is the emotion, you know. The beauty of any music is the fact that there's so many people playing
different
together.
Yeah. Exactly.
To create a whole sound.
Distracted in the city, whereas here we stay involved in the environment the whole time we're here, whereas in the city you leave.
Bye.
how did you guys get the opportunity to record out here in the parks?
Are you
with Nacho?
I don't know how it actually started. I think we just rang up and
it started with railway sessions.
Started with Frolic.
Yes, it
that's
did.
When
actually,
we met. Back.
That's when we met at Frolic Festival, which was 2 years ago, the first Frolic Festival, I think.
We met the old boys.
Tom asked to, got asked to come play. Yeah, we met there. I think we were actually looking for railway session bands, and we were like, "Does anyone want to come up and play?" And then you guys were like, "Yeah, we're very keen."
Has everyone ever told you, Sam, that you look like Kurt Cobain?
Stop telling him that, he hates it.
Where's that daddy?
Back black tea 17 times.